One of the more interesting applications of supply and demand focuses on a concept known as elasticity. Elasticity measures the relationship between two variables. When one variable changes, there's a reaction in another variable. Elasticity measures how responsive the change is. Elasticity can be applied in a variety of different ways. All you need are two variables where one moves and causes a reaction in the other. But the most common application of elasticity centers around what we call the elasticity of demand. Based on the law of demand, we know that as price goes up, the quantity demanded goes down. Elasticity of demand specifically identifies how responsive the change in quantity demand is to a change in price. Now, this requires a little bit of mathematics, but it's a very simple division problem when we look at elasticity. When we look at the elasticity of demand, what we're doing is we're taking the percentage change in quantity demanded and dividing that by the percentage change in price. Now, depending on the type of good we're looking at, elasticity can look very different from one good to the next. Consider two goods. Consider healthcare and a Caribbean vacation. Two very different goods that you would expect to have very different reactions to a price change. For instance, let's say you're working for a travel company and you want to attract more customers. So you offer to put your product on sale. One of the things that you'll oftentimes see is that a travel company will put on a big discount for a particular vacation that maybe isn't selling so well. Let's say that in order to really attract customers, they want to decrease prices or put their product on sale by 40%. If that causes a significant reaction, let's say that they increase bookings by 80%, if we take the percentage change in quantity demanded, which would be the 80%, and divide it by the percentage change in price, which would be downward 40%, then you get the number 2 as a result. 80 divided by 40 gives you 2. Now let's take a look at healthcare. People have a pretty strong desire for healthcare. They want healthcare, and they're willing to pay a lot to get it. Let's say that the healthcare company that you are currently insured by decides that they need to raise premiums, and let's say they raise them by 50%. That's the percentage change in price. We would expect there to be a decrease in quantity. Let's say that quantity demanded goes down by 25%. If we do our math, we have 25% divided by 50%, which yields us 1/2. Now the question becomes, what's the relationship or what's the difference between the vacation and your health care? Well, that's where we identify more clearly how responsive people are. We have sort of a guideline. And we use the number 1 as our guideline. 1 is the line of demarcation. If the elasticity of demand is greater than 1, we say that demand is elastic, meaning that there is a very strong response to a change in price. It's sort of like this rubber band. If you really pull hard on the rubber band and you get the rubber band to expand very, very far, we say that things are very elastic. There's a big response put on that rubber band, or a big force put on that rubber band, and it causes the rubber band to expand dramatically. That's the case of the vacation. Demand is elastic because the elasticity of demand is greater than 1. On the healthcare side, however, the elasticity of demand is less than 1. And so what we see is sort of one of those rubber bands that you put a lot of force on it, but you can't pull it very hard. There's very little response to the change, to the force that's put on the rubber band. That's referred to as being inelastic. An inelastic demand is a demand where there's not a big response in terms of percentage change to the percentage change in price. And so the elasticity of demand is less than 1. Now, before we go any further, I do want to note for you mathematicians out there, whenever we do the math with elasticity, we should always get a negative number, because demand the price and the quantity demanded are moving in opposite directions. So as price goes up, a positive number, quantity demanded goes down, a negative number, and when we do the division of a positive and a negative, we should get a negative number. Economists automatically take the absolute value of that, and that's what we're relating to one.